Hi, my name is ADHDee with two E's, and I'm here to talk to you about my experience living with OCD, thanks to Neuro Pride Ireland. So I've called my short talk, What About OCD? As an homage to the film, What About Bob? Obsessive compulsive disorder, popularly referred to as OCD, is a mental health condition characterised, unsurprisingly, by obsessive thoughts and or compulsive behaviours. OCD is a term that may sound familiar due to its common association with neatness, cleanliness, and a desire for order. Take the following exchange, for example. Upon entering my friend's home, I remark, "Wow, your house is so clean. How on earth do you manage it with two small kids?" My friend casually replies, "Thanks, I'm a little bit OCD about keeping things neat." At this point, I think of my cluttered house, inwardly cringe, and remind myself of why I don't usually mention to people that I have OCD. While it is true that many people with OCD clean excessively and or become hyper-fixated on hygiene, this does not apply to everyone with the condition. Nor is the condition itself limited to those outward displays of symptoms. My symptoms, for example, do not fit the popular understanding of what OCD entails. So let's take a closer look at OCD and how it can manifest differently from person to person. Some of you older millennials may remember the 1991 film, What About Bob? This was one of my favourite films as a child and my first introduction to a fictional character with OCD. The titular Bob Wiley, played by Bill Murray, is a patient of the egocentric psychotherapist Dr. Leo Marvin, played by Richard Dreyfuss. OCD is one of Bob's myriad of mental health conditions, which is not unusual given that studies have shown that up to 90% of adults with OCD reported having at least one comorbid mental health condition. In my case, OCD coexists with ADHD, excoriation disorder, and anxiety. What About Bob is a dark comedy, and accordingly, Bob's OCD is played for laughs. However, running alongside the humour and absurdity of Bob's actions is a realness and relatability when he describes living with OCD. The simplest way to put it? I have problems. So states Bob upon first meeting with Dr. Marvin. As blunt as it sounds, he may actually be right. The obsessions and compulsions associated with OCD are not simple quirks of character, but rather they are thoughts and behaviours that consume excessive amounts of time and energy, to the point that they can interfere with your functioning in everyday life. Your thoughts can become intrusive, distressing, and even violent. Your behaviour can affect your relationships with families, friends, and co-workers. OCD is not simply being some kind of neat freak or having a preference for order. It is a condition that can be detrimental to your mental and physical health. I worry about diseases, so I have trouble touching things, explains Bob. People with OCD indeed often have a fear of germs or contamination. Symptoms include repeatedly washing hands, protecting an assigned clean space from others, avoiding what they perceive as dirty surfaces, objects, and even people. Of course, due to the current global pandemic, such behaviours are now commonplace in the wider population. However, those with OCD are likely to take these behaviours to extremes, such as compulsively washing their hands until they crack and bleed, in order to feel the sensory relief of repeating a behaviour until they feel just right. In my own case, I do not obsess about germs. However, I actively seek the feeling of being just right. Before I knew this was a symptom of OCD, I named it equalising. One such example is that if I move my head to the right side, I must then move my head to the left side and stretch my neck muscles until both sides feel equal. Of course, as the feeling of equal is arbitrary, that means I can spend hours moving my head from side to side in a compulsive search for the right sensation. I did this all through my university lectures, to the point that issues in my neck muscles persist to this day. Or, if I catch sight of one foot while walking, I have to then look at the other, back and forth, until satisfied. Or until I walk into something. That same compulsion will take hold if I glance at one hand on the steering wheel while driving, causing me to take my eyes off the road. Unfortunately, while people with OCD generally recognised such obsessive behaviours as unhealthy, the compulsion to satisfy the urge overrides all logic. Ritualistic behaviour and urges around certain good numbers are also very common symptoms of OCD. Bob repeats, I feel good, I feel great, I feel wonderful, to make himself feel safe during stressful situations. As a young child who feared death, I would repeat the names of everyone I knew who had died while I laid in bed, in order to prevent any more people from dying. This ritual gave me control where I had none. My magic number was 4. I would divide my food into groups of 4s and not even finish a packet of sweets if there were 3 or less left. Behaviours such as knocking or tapping must also be done in 4s, according to my 5-year-old brain. Yes, OCD can present in very young children, so this is worth keeping in mind for any parents out there. In fact, OCD may be present in up to 5 in 100 children and teenagers. Bob mentions that I have a real big problem moving when referring to going outside. He describes being in his apartment as okay, but notes, when I want to go out, I get weird. While this may refer to his agoraphobia, rituals involving leaving places are associated with OCD. What if I didn't lock the front door? I might make it to the end of the driveway before turning around and trying the door handle 1, 2, 3, 4 times. It can take me up to 8 attempts to leave my property. For you, it could be many more. Or perhaps you fear you left the oven turned on, the hair straightener plugged in. What if you need to check your child is still breathing all night? These checking behaviours are usually born of the fear that you or a loved one will be harmed if the behaviours are not carried out. In the film, Bob suffers from intrusive thoughts, such as, what if my heart stops beating? What if I'm looking for a bathroom, I can't find it, and my bladder explodes? This quote in particular resonates with me. At one acutely stressful point in my life, I found myself unable to leave my bathroom. What if I needed to go again? What if my bladder wasn't empty? I'd make it to the bathroom door, turn back yet again, sit down and cry. An act that should take a few seconds could steal hours of my day, while my poor partner was frustrated and confused by my perplexing behaviour. Intrusive what-if thoughts can be a significant source of distress, and immediate help should be sought if these thoughts escalate to you experiencing ideations of harming yourself or others. Postpartum OCD is now recognised in new mothers who experience intrusive thoughts about their infant's safety. If you suspect you or someone you know has OCD, know that you are not alone. The above examples are nowhere near an exhaustive list of symptoms of OCD, as the combination varies from person to person. Cognitive behavioural therapy and/or medication may be suggested as treatment, so reach out to your GP as a starting point. Just leave Dr. Marvin out of it.